I'm very interested in like analyzing a situation, thinking about what I know and what I could use to apply to it, and then ultimately figuring out an answer and writing it out myself. So generally when I'm approaching new machine learning problems, I try to relate them to things that I do know and problems that I have solved before. And so just because it's Hamilton, ultimately you can reduce it to what's called a corpus, just like a body of words. And so then it doesn't really, like, you can apply that to anything. And so when I was thinking about creating this notebook, I was like, I can take all the lyrics and I can make them into a corpus. I can then reduce that into arrays of numbers. And then it just becomes another machine learning code with arrays of numbers. And I can do that. Yeah, I decided I wanted to start writing Hamilton lyrics with TensorFlow, and I decided to do it in R. So I guess first we just do all the imports. That's pretty standard. We're using TensorFlow and Keras. Those are great machine learning libraries. I would highly recommend them, especially for people who are kind of beginning at machine learning. So there's a data set on Kaggle, actually, of the Hamilton lyrics. So it's in a CSV, so I read the CSV, and then we take a look at the data. So the way that the user who uploaded the dataset organized it is it has the title of the song, and then it has the name of the speaker, so the character, and then it has a line. Here I'm just looking at the breakdown by song. So basically, I've got it to do all the titles of the songs and then the number of lines from each song, just to kind of see what I'm working with here. So yeah, first I just looked through the data, and some of them are like really short. And so I decided I'm going to remove all the lines that have three words or less, because I feel like those aren't particularly valuable for text generation. And now I decided I wanted to visualize the data to kind of see what words were most prominent, kind of get a feel for it. So I decided to make a word cloud just to get a sense of what words are used most often. And I mean, you can play around with the colors and the shapes. You can make them different shapes. I think it's a pretty cool way to visualize the words that are said in Hamilton. Now that we looked at it, I'm going to clean the text to prepare for input into the machine learning code. I'm just going back again, getting rid of apostrophes and other punctuation, making it lowercase, and then I'm adding it to a new column in the data frame. And then I decided I was going to split the input by song because I thought the lines were too short again. And so then I made a list of songs just like by getting the unique values of the title column. And then for each one, I go through and I basically just mash all those lines from one song together. And so once I have that, we're going to use the Keras pre-processing layers to tokenize the text, which basically tokenization is how we take a string of words and then we turn that into arrays of numbers. So the way that the tokenizer works is that you get a vocabulary. And so basically the vocabulary is obviously all the words that the tokenizer knows. And so what the tokenizer does is it has its vocabulary. For each word in its vocabulary, it's going to assign each one a number. We turn lines of words into numbers. It's each word gets a number, and then we convert those into arrays of numbers. For the tokenizer for Keras preprocessing layers, you specify the vocabulary size. And we also specify this OOV token. And OOV stands for out of vocabulary. And so what I said is basically, you're going to put this token, this OOV, wherever you find a word that's not in your vocabulary. So now that we established your tokenizer, we said what its vocabulary size is going to be, and it's out of vocabulary token. Then we're going to fit the tokenizer on text. And so what that means is now we're going to have it populate its vocabulary. So it's going to go through all the song lyrics, and it's going to figure out which words are most common, which ones are most important, and it's going to populate its vocabulary with those. And then each of those words is going to be assigned a number. And so then a tokenizer has an attribute called a word index. So that's the tokenizer's word index. And the word index is just like the mapping of words to numbers. So basically, if you know the word, then you can get the number for the vocabulary. And then if you have the number, you can use the word index to go back and get the original word. And so that's how we are able to translate afterwards from numbers back to words. So it's important that we keep the word index. We initialize the tokenizer, we fit it on the text, everything's populated and good to go. Then it will turn all of the song lyrics into arrays of numbers. And so then we're going to make sequences of numbers. So now we don't have words anymore, we just have arrays of numbers. And so what we want to do now is basically train a machine learning algorithm to read what numbers it already has and figure out what numbers go afterwards. And so the way that we do that is we're going to put together what's called n-gram sequences. And so n-grams means it's a sequence of n words. So n is like a variable. So what we're going to do is we're going to put together n-gram sequences to keep track of the different sequences of words in the text. So here I chose to make all of mine of length 10, but a lot of times people will make n-gram sequences of variable lengths and stuff like that. And that can improve your text generation output. I'm using what's called a sliding window, I think it's called, where basically like I have all these words and I'm just taking snapshots of 10 words. So I'm making the first 10 and then I'm going to move it one over. And then I'm going to start the second word and I'm going to take those 10. Then I move on to the third word, and I'm going to take the 10 after that. And that's the way that I am quantifying sequences of words and what comes next. So yeah, so basically there are a lot of words in Hamilton. And so I made 18,147 n-gram sequences. So anyway, here now we have all of our 10-gram sequences. We padded them all to be the same length, so that's cool. So now I need to split it up into labels and inputs. So the label is just going to be the last one. It's going to be that 10th word, and then the inputs are going to be the first ones. So basically you're teaching it, if you see these inputs, this is what comes next. And so then here we're going to one-hot encode them. And so once we have that, we basically are going to build and train the model. Right now I use a sequential model. Basically that just means you're putting one layer after another, and then TensorFlow will take care of the rest. And we're going to use embedding, LSTM, and dense layers. So embedding layers are super important. They're basically always used in NLP. And the way that they work is they will basically kind of put your words in the context of their meaning. So basically they will turn your words into not arrays of numbers like tokenization, but arrays of numbers in terms of meaning. And it's going to be very high dimensional. And basically words proximities in this very high dimensional space, well, if they're closer, that means they have similar meanings. And if they're farther away, that means they are less similar. And so that's kind of how we incorporate a word's meanings kind of into these models. And so then after the embedding layer, we use a bidirectional LSTM. So LSTM stands for long short-term memory layer. And basically what that's going to do is help with remembering things from the past. We have those two layers, and then we just add a dense layer, and that's what's going to kind of compact everything back down to our vocab size and be able to give us the word that we need. And then we're going to use a softmax activation. So basically here we can see the summary of the model. So we have our embedding layer, we have our bidirectional LSTM, we have a dense layer, and that's going to give us an output shape of length 5,000. So basically what this model is going to give us back is an array of length 5,000. And each element in the array is the probability of that word. So like, for example, if the word America is index 10 in the vocabulary, then at index 10 in the output, it's going to give us a value between 0 and 1. And that's the probability that America is going to be the word that comes next. So now we compile the model. Since we are using one-hot encoded labels, we're going to use a categorical cross-entropy loss. And then we just fit the model with our inputs and our encoded labels. And basically, I trained it a bunch, and I got to 92% accuracy, which is pretty good. You can plot the history, you can see the accuracy is going up, and the loss is going down, which is good. So now that we have the model, it's going to output an array of probabilities, depending on the vocabulary. We can use your model to generate new lyrics. And so generally, you start with a seed, which is like a good little starter text, something to go off of, and then it's going to predict all the words that come after that. What I did is I made a function. It's a function of the seed text, and you can set the length, but I set a default to 10. So basically what you do is you go through, you tokenize the seed text, you pad the seed text, you put it into the model, and you get out the array of probabilities. What you can do from here is just take the highest probability one, and that's your word. But what I like to do is make it into a probability distribution and randomly sample from that probability distribution, because that can give you more variation, but in like a normal way. Like if one word is slightly more likely than the other, both of them probably make sense. And so if you're generating a lot of text, you don't want like the exact same words all the time. So basically you sample based on the probability distribution and you get the output index. And then what you have is you have to go back to your word index from your vocabulary, and you have to use your output index to find the word using the word index. And so then when you find the word, you just append it to your seed text. So you stick it on your seed text, and then you go back and you do that again until you get to your desired length. And then you just return the text. So that's my writing lyrics function. And so then I just went through and I put it up, gave it a bunch of different seeds, and I let it write some lyrics. And this was interesting. This was interesting for sure. I like this one, Alexander Rise, called "Don't Like the Throne, Have Got a Congress, His Right. Sir, with them eloquently drop, drop. We like married it." That's one of my favorite ones. And then here I specified a different length just to show that you can. That is writing Hamilton lyrics. I think these came out really interesting. I like to think that they could have been written by Lin-Manuel Miranda, but maybe I'll write the second one with this.